Good morning, students. In earlier class, so we discussed that how the design of center crankshaft is performed. So in today's class, so let us see the design of center crankshaft. So by using a simple example problem. Clear? So before going that, let us go through the brief reviews of what are the various components in center crankshaft. So center crankshaft. So in that. So we have three components. One is the cranking, another one is web, and another one is main gerbil. So in which we are taking a consideration that so the total crankshaft is considered as a simply supported beam. So supported at the main gerbils, two main gerbils. So in here in the central crankshaft, the crank pin is supported by means of two number of webs and the two number of main gerbils. So it is supported at the main gerbils and supported by means of two webs, so that the total load acting on the crank pin is going to equally distributed among the two number of webs and the main gerbils. Clear? So let us go through the design. So using the example problem. So here it is an example problem for center crankshaft. So let us see, it is a single throw type. So we discussed that what is a throw. So it means so based upon the different number of cylinders available for that particular engine, so the types of throws are varies. So if the connecting rods or crankshaft having the single cylinder, so that is a single crank pin is enough. So that for that case, so we call it as a single throw. If it is a multi-cylinder engine, so it is having the number of crank pins, so that we are called as a multi-throw. So it is a single throw type center crankshaft. So it is designed for a diesel engine, and it is carrying a flywheel at one end of each end of the gerbils, and their weight is also given here, the weight of the flywheel, and there's given specifications or diameter. So we know that the diameter is denoted by capital D, and the stroke length, so we are generally denoted with L. So but here the L, so L can be taken, or we are using for the length of crank pin as well as the length of the main gerbil. So length of crank pin is denoted by LC, and the length of the main gerbil is denoted by capital. So here the stroke length we can simply take and denoted by L. So on length of connecting rod we can denote with capital L, but here we can also denote the length of main gerbil can also denote with capital. So that the reason we can simply left this connecting rod so without notating any symbol. So and the diameter, the distance from flywheel to the nearest gerbil taken as Y, and the speed capital N, and the maximum gas pressure we denote with the P max. So maximum gas pressure, and the allowable stresses is given in bending and the shear and in crushing or bearing. So that is 70, 40 and 8 Newton per meter square, and maximum torque angle is given, that is maximum load acting at the crank angle, so that is 30, that is denoted by theta. Clear? So this is the given data. So we know that so for the crankshaft, so we are taken proportions like so LC and DC for crank pin. So it is the dimensions for crank pin. And for web, so W, small w, that is width of web, and it is the thickness of web. Here, so width and thickness is uniform, and so L, capital L and capital D, so that are length and diameter of major. So here, so the stresses induced in each case, we are already discussed in the earlier session. So in today's class, let us go with how to calculate the dimension. Design, we are going to calculate all these six dimensions, as well as you can also check with the induced stresses, that is allowable stresses. So initially, so this is a given data, so capital D, L and capital L, and W is the weight of the flywheel, so as I stated, and Y is the distance from flywheel to the nearest support, and the speed is denoted by N, and it is a not P, it is a P max, maximum gas pressure 1 Newton per mm square, and these are the allowable stress values. So these we can check with the induced values. And before going to the main dimensions of the crankshaft, we need to calculate the loads acting, that is a radial load and tangential loads acting on the connecting rod. That for that case, we require the maximum gas load acting. So we know that how to calculate the maximum gas load. That is Fg is given by W, that is pi by 4 d square into p. So we can case, we can also denote with F or Fg. So pi by 4 d square into p. So p max, that is p max. So p max is known and d is known. So by substituting both the values, so we get the maximum gas load, 31416 newtons. Clear? So using that, so but in the problem itself, they mentioned clearly, so the maximum load acting at the crank angle of theta 30 degrees. So for that we are having a relation, so sin theta, sin phi equal to sin theta by L by R. So where L by R is the ratio of length of connecting rod to the crank radius. So crank radius is not given. So that is calculated, that is determined from the stroke length. So stroke length is given. So we know the relation of the stroke length, L is twice of crank radius, L equal to R, and L is the length of connecting rod, that is known. So by substituting both the values, L by R and theta is given 30 degrees. So from that we can calculate the value of phi. So that is 7.18 by substituting the both the values, we may get the 7.18. So we can also calculate the theta plus phi value. So that is the included angle. So 30 plus 7.18, that is 7.18. So using these included angle, so where we may get the maximum load, so we can calculate the radial load and tangential loads. So let us see. So here that is the radial load. So radial load acting is given by F cos theta plus phi. So you can calculate the radial load, and then tangential load, so F sin theta plus phi. So by substituting, so F is nothing but in that is the maximum gas load. So by calculating that, we can get the value of tangential load and maximum gas, that is the radial load. So after that we can go with the design of crankwheel. So crankwheel is subjected to the three types of stresses. So one is so that is a direct stress, that is a bending stress, the load, direct load acting on the crankwheel. So we are seeing that, so this is in the case of crankwheel. So like in this fashion, so load is acting here at the center of the crankwheel. So due to the load that acting on the crankwheel, that is a gas load, so the pin is going to bend, that is the bending load. Here we are taking consideration that so the crankshaft is as then simply supported, being supported at the main journals, so that the maximum bending moment is fx by 4. So x is the distance between the two supports. So from that is the one of the stress, the bending stress acting on the cranking. And the second one is a direct shear load, that is the direct shear stress induces. And the third one is bearing stress. So here in which so the, all the allowable stresses, out of which all the allowable stresses, the crushing stress is the least one. So that here the design, the diameter and length is going to calculate based upon the crushing stress value. So here for that crushing stress or bearing stress, you know that the crushing stress equal to bearing load by bearing area, L into DC. And bearing load means what? The amount of load acting, that is maximum gas load. So in the design of crankwheel, so we are not consider any radial load and tangential load component of process. Why? Because it does not produce any effect, so that we can directly take in the total gas load acting on the crankwheel for the design of crankwheel. Clear? So that reason, so we are taking for the bearing stress, bearing load as a total gas load F. So by LC into DC is the bearing area, LCDC. So here, so F is known and sigma C is the permissible value, that is 8 Newton per mm square, that is given. But here, so LC is unknown, so here we are taken, so length of crankwheel in terms of diameter, so 1.525 times of DC, 1.25 DC. So we can substitute here DC in terms of DC, so length in terms of DC. So from that we can calculate the DC as 60 mm and length as 72 mm. Clear? That is the dimensions of crankwheel. So after that you can also need to check whether these dimensions are withstand with by the application of the load. So that we need to check by the induced stress with respect to the allowable stress. So for calculating the checking of induced stress with the allowable stress, we need to know the distance between the two centers, so that before going to check the induced stress of the crankwheel, we can design the web. So then only we can get the distance between the two channels, that is the x value. so that without going to check the end user stress, I am going with the design of remaining components like main journal and web. So here it is a main journal. So here the main journal in this case, it is subjected to the torsional load due to radial load. So tangential load due to tangential load and the bending stress and the bending load. So it is main journal is going to bend. So why? Because it is in the fashion. So it is a web portion. So here we get the main journal. So at the end of the main journal, we can place an flywheel. So here the weight of the flywheel is going to act. So it is a support. So it is a distance load. Clear? So the y is given. So due to the load offset distance from the support to the overhang distance y, so the bending moment is going to cause. So before that, it is subject to the both twisting moment and bending moment. So that we need to calculate equivalent bending stress and equivalent torsional shear stress. So that the torque is going to calculate using this relation. So that is Ft by 2. Here y 2 is taken means, as I stated, it is considered, we are considering this as a simply supported beam. So the total load acting on the cranking is going to distribute equally distribute among the two number of webs and the two number of journals. So that the total tangential force acting on the web pin is going to divide as an equal half of the two number of webs as well as the journals. So that here we can take the half of the tangential load into half. So we know that the tangential load we have already calculated tangential component. So and R is the crank radius that is calculated. So from that we can calculate the torque acting of the main journal. So similarly, bending moment acting on the main journal due to weight of the flywheel. So weight of the flywheel W is given and the overhang distance is given. M is equal to W into Y. So we may get 300 into 10 cube Newton. So here it is subjecting to the both the torque and the bending moment. So we need to calculate the equivalent bending moment and the equivalent twisting moment. So for that, so equivalent bending moment is calculated by M equal to 1 by 2 into M plus root of M square plus T square. So I may get the value of 878 10 cube Newton mm. And then I am going to calculate the bending stress due to this equivalent bending moment. So 32 M by 5 cube. So here, so sigma b, so I can take use an allowable stress value here. So equivalent bending moment is calculated 878 newton mm. From that I calculated the value of diameter capital D, so by considering of bending of main journal. Similarly, you can also need to calculate the diameter based upon the equivalent twisting moment. So let us see. So equivalent twisting moment, we know that that is root of m square plus t square, and the shear stress, the torsional shear stress, obviously given by 16 by pi d cube. So according to that criteria, we can also find the diameter. So let us see. So here equivalent torque is given by t equal to m square plus t square, 1445 into 10 cube Newton mm I may get. So and then torsional shear stress 16 by pi d cube. So again here tau is taken as allowable shear stress, and from that I calculate to find out the diameter as 57 mm. So after finding out the diameter based upon the equivalent bending moment and equivalent twisting moment, so here we need to take the larger of the two values as a final diameter for the main journal. So here it is a 57, I am taking a roundup value as 60 mm. So that is a fixing as 60 mm as a final diameter of a main journal, and length of the journal is going to find out by using the proportion 1.25 sorry 2 times of D. So that is a 72 mm. So here we are not going to finding out any induced stresses. Why? Because we are finding out the dimensions by means of the induced that is a permissible value. So no need to check with the induced stresses for the main journal. And further, so on the next component in the design, that is the crankshaft, so that is design of web. So in the design of web, we are having the two dimensions, one is the width and thickness of web. So here the width and thickness of web is finding out by using the proportions. So and these two proportions are based on the diameter of the crank pin. So clear? So after finding out the dimensions using the proportions, we need to check with the induced stress values. So this is the design of web. So thickness of web is going to use by means of proportions, and thickness of web is calculated by 1.7D. So D means it is a DC, as well as the W is equal to width of web is equal to 1.1 times of D. It is also DC, so that is 7 meter. Okay, and the central distance between the gyros, as I stated, the distance between the center supports is to be calculated when we finding out the thickness and width. So after that, we go with the induced stresses for the crack. So here it is given by L by 2, so that is a half length of main journal. So it is not smaller, it is capital L by 2, plus thickness of webs, plus total length of crankin, that gives the distance between the two supports of main journal. So, and that is given by the value of 234L. So after finding out the width, the thickness and the distance between the main supports, we can go with the checking of the induced stresses in both the crankin and web. So first of all, I can check for the web. So the web is subjected to the three types of stresses. One is a direct stress, that is a direct axial stress, and the second one is bending stress due to radial load, and another one is bending stress due to tangential load. So here it is a direct stress, that is a load, sigma naught is given by load by area. So here again the load is going to taken as only half, so that FR by 2 into W into T, that is a cross sectional area, is a rectangular W into T. So the stress value, the induced stress is only 4 Newton per mm square. And the second one is bending stress due to radial load, sigma BR. So again it is a half load, so 1.5 FR into X minus 1 LC plus T by WT square, that is a cross section area again WT square. So that is so bending moment equation, so sigma B by M by Z. So likewise the moment is use the moment, water moment. So and here WT square by 6, so like that FR by 2 you may either get 1.5. So you can substitute LC is known, so length of crankin and thickness is calculated, and X is the distance between the supports, 234 mm, and width and thickness is known. So it is given the value of 31 Newton per mm square. Similarly, there is a subjecting to the bending stress due to tangential load. So I can denote with sigma BD. So it is given by 3 FTR into EW square. So again, FTR is known and B is known, W is known. You can substitute. It is given 39 Newton per mm square. But it is an individual stresses induces in the web. But the total stress induced in the web is given by the sum of the direct stress and the bending stress due to radial load and bending stress due to the tangential load. That means the 4 plus, that is sigma naught plus sigma BR plus sigma BD, that gives the total stress induced in the web. So that is given by 4 plus 31 plus 39. So here that is the total induced stress in the web, sigma naught plus sigma BR plus sigma BD. So that gives 74 Newton per mm square. Clear? But here the allowable stress is not up to the mark of 74, so it is only 60 Newton per mm square. So that the dimensions whatever we have provided for the web is not in the safe condition. So that reason we are going to change the dimensions. So by writing the simple statement here, so that is the induced stress is not, is more than the allowable value. So let us increase the dimension. That is one of the dimension, the main dimension in the web, it is only width. So I am increasing only the width, not the thickness. The width of the web is taken 80 mm instead of 70 mm. That is, so earlier we are taken, so we are taken width is 70 mm. So I am increasing this width up to 80 mm. So after increasing the width 80 mm, we need to calculate, we need to find out the induced stresses again, that is a direct stress at the bending stress due to radial load and the bending stress due to tangential load. We need to calculate again, once again using this width 80 mm. So I calculated that. You can also check the value with this. So it is given as 60.5 Newton per mm square, that is almost equal to the permissible value, so that the design, whatever the dimensions you have taken, is going to be safe for the web. So that whenever the web design is safe, then we can go with the induced stresses in the crankin. So why? Because so whenever it is okay, so that the distance between the two main journal supports is going to be okay. So that first check with the stresses in the well, then we go with the stresses in the rank. So here I can have the value as the same of the allowable stress, so that the design of the LBCF, so that I am going forward with the induced stresses for the cranking. So here induced stresses of the cranking, as I stated, so it is subject to the three types of stresses. One is direct stress, bending stress, and the bearing stress. The dimensions we are already finding out by means of the bearing stress. So we need to check the induced stress for the remaining two stresses, that is the bending stress and direct stress. So here the bending stress is a simply supported beam. So fx by 4. So we need to take the total load here in the crank pin, that is considering any effect of component of forces. We have taken direct force, that is a gas load here. So 4x by 4. So x is the distance again. So as I stated that, so whenever we can find out the thickness values and width values, then only we may get the distance between the support, that is x here. So that is 224 mm. So we are finding out the bending moment acting on the crank pin. So and the bending stress is given by 32 mm by dc cube. So it is given 87. Again, the induced stress in crank pin exceeds the allowable value. So that the design of crank pin is not safe. So here we need to increase the diameter. So I taken the diameter as 65 mm instead of 60 mm. So initially we get a 60 mm diameter for crank pin, but here due to the increase of the induced stress, so I am going to increase the diameter of crank pin as 65 mm instead of 60. Then again I can substitute the value of 65 here, so in this place. So I can find out the stress values are 68 Newton per mm square. The allowable stress is 70, I think, so that the design is going to be safe. So similarly, so that is what, so after that you can also find out the direct stress, that is a sigma or sigma naught or sigma, so that is a 4f by dc square. So we can also check these direct stress or actual stress here, sigma a or sigma naught or direct stress or sigma t. So we can check the direct shear stress, it is not actual stress, it is subjected to the shear, direct shear. So that we can also check the direct shear stress for the cranking. So most probably it is in the safe region, you can also check with the direct shear stress for the cranking. So here, so we are find out the dimensions of crank pin and the length of crank pin, and the dimensions of width and thickness of web, and we find out the diameter of main journal and length of the main journal. So after that we can check the induced stresses for web as well as the induced stresses for crank pin. Clear? So that is what we are finding out the crank pin. The dimensions of crank pin is a diameter BC and length LC, and the dimensions of the that is width W, thickness T, and dimensions of our design of main journal, so that is capital L and capital T. So here capital L is by means of proportions, and WD is also by means of proportions, and these DC and LC. So LC is also by means of proportion we are finding out. So but here DC is calculated by means of sigma C. From the crushing stress we are going to calculate the diameter of crank pin. So after that, so we are not checking any induced stresses. Why? Because we don't know the distance between the two main supports. So for that reason we can proceed with the another design. So we can find out the D diameter, that is by considering the two conditions. So one is equivalent bending moment, that is equivalent twisting moment. So out of which one is the larger value taken as the final diameter for main journal. So and then using this D you can find out the length of journal. So after that, so both these width and thickness is going to be calculated by means of proportions. So after finding out the proportions of web, so we can check the dimensions for web by calculating the induced stresses, that is a direct stress and bending stress due to radial load and bending stress due to tangential load, and the total stress is given by sum of all the stresses, that is sigma naught plus sigma pr plus sigma bd. So after finding out the induced stresses, we can check the allowable value, If the design of the V safe, you can go with the design, check the design for crank. So here the design stresses, excess bending stress and shear stress for. Clear? Simple here. So only the 6 dimensions we need to find out. So out of which 1, 2, 3 and 4 dimensions are using to use it to calculate by means of proportions, and the remaining you can find out by means of the here diameter as well as the BC is calculated by means of allowable stress. After that you can check with the induced stresses. We can find out the induced stresses or the stresses induced in the component. We can find out the remaining time, that is whether it is the design is going to withstand or not. We can check with the allowable value. If it is not withstanding, it is going to be exceeding. So we can increase the dimensions to the next possible extent so that we can find out, we can check with the values. Clear? So in the next class, we can see, we can go with another example. So we can also go through the example problems. So what are given or described in the question bank, you can practice well with the some number of examples so that you may get an idea regarding the design. So in the next class, we can start unit number 2. Thank you.